In the previous video of series programs, we did few questions, and today also we'll be doing few more series programs. The link of the PDF is given in the description box. You may download that, check. Any problem, you can comment. So let's start. The first question says to write a program to find the sum of harmonic series, and this series is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 up to 1 by n. Previous video also I told you that you observe the terms and check how the next term is coming, which pattern it is following. So here also if we observe this series, the numerator is 1 in all the terms and denominator is starting from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n. Although in first it is not written by 1, but that is understood. So 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n, it is increasing from 1 till n with a step of 1. So the last term value n will input from the user. We have to find the sum. So here we'll take float sum equals to 0.0f. This f can be written in capital or in small, because 1 by 2, 1 by 3 will not give you the answer in integer. So to find the sum, we'll take the float value. Then we'll take the loop int I equals to 1. This loop is for the denominator 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 I less than equals to n. 1 se start ho raha hai denominator aur kahan tak? N tak. I plus plus, and after that you will say sum equals to sum plus each term we will calculate here. So that calculation will be float type 1 by I. So 1 by I, first time it will be 1 by 1. Second time 1 by 2, this will be calculated and stored in float format, and the final value will be added to sum. So after completion of this loop, in sum variable will have the value of this series from first to n terms. So after that you will print, you will display using print statement, and print ln sum is equals to plus sum. Now whatever we write within double quotes is displayed as it is, and the value of the variable which is given here, that value will be displayed on the screen. Then you close main and then you close class. Like this, different series are there. The next question says to input a number and check whether it is a pronic number or not. The definition of pronic number says that a number is said to be pronic if it is the product of consecutive two integers. Let's take the example 0. 0 is the product of 0 and 1. So 0 is pronic. Next number we take 2. 1 into 2 is 2. So 2 is the pronic number. 6, 2 and 3. 2 consecutive integers. So this is pronic. 20. 4 into 5 is 20. So these are the pronic numbers. Pronic numbers are also known as oblong, rectangular or heteromachic numbers. So any term can be asked in the question. It is the product of two consecutive integers. I or I plus 1. 2 and 3. आपको दो कंसेक्यूटिव नंबर्स कैसे मिलेंगे? फर्स्ट नंबर में अगर आप 1 ऐड करते हो तो नेक्स्ट नंबर आपको मिलेगा. टू फाइंड दिस लेट्स इनपुट द नंबर n इक्वल्स टू se डॉट नेक्स्ट int. हियर आई एम टेकिंग अ फ्लैग वैल्यू इक्वल्स टू 0 व्हिच इंडिकेट्स इफ इट इज 0 एट द एंड ऑफ द लूप दैट मींस नंबर इज नॉट प्रॉनिक. और जैसे ही हम कंडीशन चेक करेंगे, हमारी कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई होगी, हम फ्लैग की वैल्यू को चेंज कर देंगे. सो दैट विल बी यूज्ड एज इंडिकेटर. जब तक हमको प्रॉनिक चेकिंग नहीं है तब तक ये जीरो है, जैसे ही प्रॉनिक मिलेगा हम इसको वन कर देंगे। नाउ लेट्स टेक द लूप, हियर विल यूज द लूप फ्रॉम आई इक्वल्स टू जीरो, बिकॉज जीरो इज ऑल्सो प्रॉनिक, सो मल्टीप्लीकेशन हम जीरो और वन का करके चेक करेंगे कि जीरो प्रॉनिक है कि नहीं है। आई लेस देन एन, आई प्लस प्लस, एंड हियर यू विल चेक इफ आई और आई में कौन सा नंबर, नेक्स्ट नंबर कैसे फाइंड करेंगे, आई प्लस वन। अगर ये दोनों नंबर्स का प्रोडक्ट एन के बराबर है, इट इज इक्वल्स टू एन, तो हम फ्लैग की वैल्यू कर देंगे वन, मतलब हमको यहाँ पे प्रॉनिक नंबर की कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई हो रही है, और विल ब्रेक एंड विल कम आउट ऑफ द लूप। और अगर नहीं है ये, तो फिर नेक्स्ट टाइम होता जाएगा, टिल लेस देन एन दिस लूप विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड। आफ्टर दैट यू विल चेक इफ फ्लैग इज इक्वल्स टू वन, अगर फ्लैग की वैल्यू वन है, किस केस में वन हुई थी, जब ये कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई थी, मतलब दो कंसेक्यूटिव नंबर्स का प्रोडक्ट एन है, तो दैट मींस द डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रॉनिक नंबर इज सेटिस्फाइड हियर, सो द फ्लैग इज वन। सो अगर ये ऐसा है तो हम प्रिंट कर देंगे कि इट्स अ प्रॉनिक नंबर, यू विल प्रिंट इट इज अ प्रॉनिक नंबर। Else, और अगर वन नहीं हुआ, that means it is not a pronic number, you will print system.out.print statement is used to display the output. It is not a pronic number. It is not a pronic number, and then you close your main and you close your class. I hope this program is clear. Any doubt, any problem, you please comment. I'll answer your question in the comment box. Next, we move on to the question which says input a number and check whether it is an even number or not. An even number is also known as Hashed number. Now, what is the definition of an even number? It says if the number is divisible by sum of its digits, then that number is said to be an even number. Let's take the example 18. The sum of the digits are 18, that is equals to 9. 18 mod 9 equals to 0. So 18 is an even number. 24. 2 plus 4 is 6. 24 mod 6 equals to 0. So 18, 24, these are the even numbers. So how to find the sum of the digits? For finding the sum, we'll start with the number 18, will take mod 10, which will result in the remainder and give you 8. So one digit we have got. To find the next digit, we will do slash 10 and will find the quotient. 1 mod 10 will give you 1. So 8 and 1. These two numbers are present in this. Then we'll find the sum of these. And next, if I'll try to do 1 slash 10, it will be 0. So till how long we have to repeat this process? Till the quotient is more than 0. So here, although here you are getting 1, but again I have taken the remainder, because this number entered by the user can be 2 digit, 3 digit or n digit number. So you will use a method to find the remainder, and the next number how you will get? By taking the quotient, and to get the quotient we will use slash operator. For modulus slash operator, you can refer to the video operators and expressions in Java, which is present in this channel. Now here, let's start. We'll input the number n using scanner object, and we'll take the loop int I equals to n, because we'll be starting with the number. So I equals to n, I greater than 0. till it is more than 0, we have to repeat the process. And how you will get the next I value? I equals to I slash 10, the next quotient. Then to find the remainder, you say int a equals to I mod 10. This is how you are extracting digit by digit from the number. And s equals to s plus a. After completion of this loop, in s you will have the total sum of the digits of the number. After that you will check if s is equals to n, you will print it is a neven number. Else print not a neven number. Now in this program here I have done using for loop, but in the PDF link you will see that this program I have done with while loop. So any method which you want you can use, or any looping statement can be used for solving the problems. The next question says to input a number and check whether it is a neon number or not. Just now we did neven number, now it is neon number. Don't get confused, the definition will always be there in the question. Neon number kya hota hai? If the sum of the digits of the square of the number is equal to the number, then that number is known as neon number. Check karte example se, if I have taken 9, the square of 9 is equals to 81. The sum of the digits of the square of the number is 8 plus 1, that is equals to 9. So which is equal to the entered number, hence 9 is a neon number. Now let's do the program. Now for this, just now we did in neven also how to find the sum of the digits. अब यहाँ पर हमको किसके डिजिट्स का सम चाहिए? इस नंबर के स्क्वायर का. So first we'll input the number and then we'll find the square value of n. SQ equals to n into n. And for finding the sum, let's take the variable s equals to 0. Now for the loop, int I equals to, कहां से शुरू करेंगे? SQ से. अभी अभी मैंने आपको लॉजिक समझाया. You can just play little back to check the logic. Till this is greater than 0, next value के लिए I equals to I slash 10. And now you will find int A equals to I mod 10. I mod 10 हमेशा हमको क्या देगा? Right most digit देगा. और इसको हम s वेरिएबल में ऐड करते जाएंगे. आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द लूप इन s वेरिएबल यू विल हैव द सम ऑफ द डिजिट्स ऑफ sq वेरिएबल. sq वेरिएबल कंटेन्स द स्क्वायर ऑफ द नंबर. सो हियर यू विल गिव इफ s इक्वल्स टू n. S is contains the sum of the square of the number. If S equals to N, you simply have to print that it is a neon number. It's a neon number. Else, not a neon number should be printed. So whenever you are printing, print using proper message, and printing statements are system.out.print and println statement. I hope these two statements are clear. If not, please let me know using comment. I'll explain you. After this, you will close main and you will close class. Now, I hope this program is also clear to you. For today, this much only. Next, also we'll have one more video of series programs. You can comment which series programs you want so that next turn I'll be taking those programs in the video. Any problem, please do comment. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, please do so and press the bell icon so that you get notifications and no important topic is missed by you. Keep practicing, keep doing the programs. God bless you.